Welcome all, I am Dheeraj Rani. Today presenting a tutorial on MIP App Inventor, where we are going to see the demo how to connect to the database, that is the extended database Firebase. Okay, so in this particular tutorial we will see first of all how to create database with the Firebase. So very simple thing is that you must have a Gmail ID and you go to this particular URL console.firebase.com. It will ask you by default if you are already logging with the Gmail ID, or you may choose it even. So I'm logging here with my Gmail ID. Okay, so I log in it. So now I will create a new database. Here I'm giving some name for the database. Remember that it is not only a database but the project, it may have the many more. So I am using here the name, that is a DR database, and continue. Make it enable and accept all. Account it will like to select if you are the multiple one login. So I am going to, so Dheeraj Rani I have selected, create project. It is taking time due to the network delay. About the coming. Okay, so my project is ready with the name Dear Database. Now continue. So we will have this particular screen here. Okay, our project is got ready. Come to the database. Okay, so these are the database features. I am going to create a one database. Make it in the test mode because I have to have the less number of the securities. Okay, this is a demo purpose. I am using the test mode. This will be active for the 30 days only. Fine. You may select the from which particular area we belong. Just now I am from the Asia. I am trying to get select out of it. Whatever is best suited for. So I like to select Asia East to. Yeah. Okay. Asia Northeast. Fine. Not done. This particular setting cannot be changed later on. Okay. We are about to get the database now. In this tutorial, I will try to minimize all the restrictions like the security, the rules and everything. I will make it eligible everything. Okay. So here we can start the new database collection. Okay. Now rules has to define here. Okay. Before that, I must have to go with the real-time database. Not the rules. Okay, so we have to copy this particular string. This is the URL for our database. Okay, now we are going to the rules. So rules by default are false here. The read is false, write is false. We'll make it true. Fine. And publish it. So it will get saved. And now this particular database can be accessible from any other project. Note down, we have just noted the URL. Okay, the other thing I want to know about it, that is a web API key. This is another thing that we have to remember. Kindly copy it and save somewhere. So two things we have captured from here. One is the database URL, another is the web API key. This is will be useful for the our project development. Is that clear? Okay, now next job is that creating the mobile application. This particular task I will divide among the two parts. One is the designing the front view, another is the block view. So creating a new project, start new project, give some project name. Fine. you may use any name. Okay, so I am creating the project with the name Firebase Database. Okay, so screen one is here. Screen I have stored. We may change the title of the screen. So Firebase Database Demonstration Demo, the name of my screen. About the screen, I can give some basic information. So I am adding here database. Firebase DB. Now we know that we have already copied two strings. One is the web URL, another is the API key. So copy it from that I have stored with my notepad. I am copying that database URL. I will store it to the Firebase URL. The next job is that the Firebase token, that is the web API we have just copied. Okay, fine. Now we are ready to use this particular Firebase database. Now we are only remaining with the GUI designing. So for this purpose, I am using two buttons to store. Okay. So we store the button. I will rename it as a store. Okay, so as make it the store. We may change the text also. So I am just using this particular layout for the demonstration and visible purpose also. It is nothing to do with the technicality of the database. So fill fire end to get it horizontal complete way. Okay, background color I am using the light gray. Okay, light gray. Now again I am adding one of the word horizontal arrangement. Okay, now in that vertical there are three horizontal arrangements, means in one vertical arrangement there will be the three sections which will be work horizontally. It is completely for the designing purpose. It has nothing to do with the technical working of this project. Okay. Now label just to indicate the tag value, and a text box to add tag value. Is it clear? So I will rename it. Rename. So this is the something related that I should get remember. That I should get remember. Okay, that is a tag label. Writing the text on it, that is a tag text. So it is button tag. Add tag here. This is label 2. This is for the value data. This is for the value data. So name given for the text box, text value. Okay, so we are ready with this particular window. Okay, dear students, now we have finished with the front end. Okay, now we are going to do the background coding. So we are having the one button for the storing purpose, that is store.click. Okay, so whenever we'll use the click, it will store the data with the database. So Firebase, now there is a procedure, store value. You can see it here. So store value, I'm going to take the tag from the text box 1 and the value from the text box 2. We already rename it as a text tag and text value. So you can take it from it. No issue to get which field you are used. You may change it here. Now another is the text value. Okay. So this code is enough to store our information with the Firebase database. Okay. Now next job is to retrieve information. So retrieve button. So similarly, with the Firebase, we will have a subroutine. Okay. So get value. Now here the tag we will use from the text box 1. We may take it duplicate directly. That's the same thing, same field I am going to use. Okay, And if I'm not getting that value, it will return me the error. Okay. So if that particular information is not available with my Firebase, it will return me the error. Another thing is that when I retrieve the value, I want to display it somewhere to show it. So Firebase, here is the event when data retrieved. Okay. We have got the value. So we'll set this particular values to the label we have designed with the front view. Okay. So we are having the value. Okay, so I am storing that value with the same value, the text value. Now we will, in demonstration, we will delete it and we will see the value is coming back. Okay, so this is the core how we are retrieving the particular information from the database. Okay, so this is all about how we are going to use the background code. Now again, this is data change. We are going to state do some of the more initializations. So there is a label I have added which will also show this particular information. So this label, the property I want to set, that is the text. Okay. Now the same data will be stored here. So here we will like to add the tag also and value also. So I will join here because there are the two values. One is the tag, another is the value. Okay. So this is, I am getting the tag from here and other is the value. So we'll have both the things, tag and value. Okay. That's it. So after the data will be changed, this particular event will get fired only when the data get changes with particular databases. Okay. Okay. Up to so far, I have created the application. Now I am connecting it to the particular web component. Okay, the mobile component. So it is available with me. Now this code will be get scanned by my mobile. Okay, and after that, okay, let's wait. It's taking some of the network time. Okay, now it is loading with the system. And now this is the output you can see. Now this is the output we can see. I am adding this particular value, the tag value. Okay. And this is the data value. So we can see when I will say store it here, it will get reflected to my database. So I'm using store. So this is what store. Okay, and this is retrieving.
So whatever may be the query you have related to this classes, you can type on chat box so that I can able to clear all the.
You can see here, when this particular values got added, this particular data has reflected with this database. Okay, I not make the synchrony to run the both the videos simultaneously, but you can understand it when I add the value here, it is got stored here. Okay. And that's all, dear students. This is the way how we can work with the database.